You too. Welcome back, man. Peep this out. You see the thumbnail? Ulterior Motives tapers. But before we get started, do me a favor. Again and again and again. Subscribe to the channel, man. Share it up. Like, comment. Do what it do. Getting back to the topic. We chopped the Lexus up. I started the process already yesterday. I got almost three fenders done. I still need to weld and seal everything, shape it, mold it, you know, get it prepped and ready for paint. Today, I'm gonna show you the one that I have left. And it's the best one to show you anyways because it's the rears. It's a little more complicated than the front. It's real simple. So I'm gonna explain it a little bit more once I get to it, all right? Alright gang, there you go. We got front and rears pretty much finished. I'm gonna get the front a little bit more touched up. I still feel like I can get away with another centimeter or so. Come up right here, slice it all off. This part of the bumper as well. Just for turning radius, man. I think we're safe back here. I really don't wanna slice anymore, honestly. Once I throw my lower fenders on there, I'm gonna need this part. I'm not gonna slice anymore right here. Definitely right here, just for turning radius. And the back end, initially I wanted to stop right here. There was a huge chunk of metal sticking out right here. After I did all of this, the homies is like, yo, you gotta chop that because once I push the wheels out more, it's gonna give me issues. And if you look at it specifically, I can see where there could be clearance problems. Same thing with this side. It looks ghetto as shit, but once the tapers are slapped on, it covers it all completely. Weld all of this up, put sealer on it, then we can slap the taper on and start tack welding and finishing it all off. But that won't be in this vlog. What I'm gonna show you is the process of the rears. I'm pretty sure there's a million videos on how to do rear fender flares. It's a lot of cutting, folding, grinding, welding, all that good stuff. I'm gonna show you my point of view. Just because I don't see too many videos that caters to this chassis, man, to be honest. There's a lot of dope cinematic videos, but not really anybody documenting the process or progress on certain things. I told y'all already, we got new mirrors. I don't record this side that much because I gotta take care of that bodywork right there, which shouldn't be too bad. The rest of the car is pretty gravy. Little rock chips here and there. Let's get to it, man. Alright, as you can see in that time lapse, I made guidelines. My Sharpie was taking a shit on me, so it's all good. I just needed that mini guideline to really mark this part. Probably gotta cut in much deeper and a lot lower. The folds in the metal right here sticks out so much even after you cut the individual slices underneath this fender right here. It's not like the front where you could just chop off. It's actually two layers folded underneath your wheel well. And you gotta be careful. The lining on the rear is, it's like carpet, man. You gotta be careful not to cut too deep because you might start a fire. I'm gonna have the water hose ready just in case. Alright gang, I got the top layer off. This is what we have. So I ended up trimming straight across right here just so I could view what is actually behind here. See right here, this is what I was talking about. This fold right here sticks out so much. You look at it right here, it'll definitely get in the way once I push the wheels out. This definitely gotta be chopped. I cut it just enough and I'll just take small chunks out of it slowly once I start to fold all of these, which I'm gonna make guidelines for also. Just to let y'all know, man, I'm not a professional. I'm not liable for any damages or injuries. Do it at your own risk, all right? I'm not taking any responsibility for this, for anybody else's action. I'm doing this to my own vehicle. I don't mind messing up. I'll still be able to repair it somehow and not have a headache about. So I got it sanded down, man. Cleaned up the edges a little bit. Went a little higher up here. But when I weld, I have plenty of raw metal to weld on. And then at the same time, whenever I start shaping it, I may even feather it out a little bit more. Whenever I start shaping it with filler, I have something real good to grab to. In this video, I'm probably just gonna make these cuts right here and fold it up. I'm not gonna do any welding today. Probably in the next vlog, tack the tapers on all four as well. I'm gonna show y'all how I started my guidelines to cut these individual strips to fold, and we'll go from there. So what I did was I just used my tool that came with the grinder. I just slapped it pretty much dead center and started marking. Simple, man. I mean, you could use a ruler, whatever. Let me show y'all one more time on this side. I gotta start welding. I banged it up with a hammer a little bit to flush it out. I gotta clean it up again since, you know, it's building up a little surface rust. It's no big deal right now. All right, let's get the cutting. So we got all of the little individual sections, fins, as you can call it. The bolt holding the bumper is right here. Same goes with this one. It's a tab on the inside, so no worries. There is a bolt right here that holds it up also. All I'm gonna do is use plier right here to pull it up as much as I can. It's nowhere near perfect right now. I still have to trim this liner. Y'all probably wondering, why didn't I just take the wheel off? I felt like I had enough precision to do it without having the hassle to take the wheel off, jack the car up, and take this liner off, which I really don't want to delete. I'm just gonna cut it. This wheel well actually goes in pretty damn deep, man. There won't be any rubbing whatsoever. I was actually tucking a little bit already at the height I was at. Yeah, it's a process, man. It looks like shit right now, but guess what? It's gonna end up looking the same as the other side, man. There we have it, our finished product. You see the process, how tedious it was, and that was already a good couple hours right there. We're gonna go ahead and mount the taper on with the clecos, show y'all how the whole car looks like with tapers on it. I've got sunshine in my pocket, I'm just right here in my zone. I've got Sade in my tape deck, I'm just moving right along. All these haters really love me, they just pretend that they don't. Cause I've got sunshine in my pocket, I'm just right here in my zone, in my zone. There you have it, man. I'm gonna tell you, on the fronts, all you gotta do is line it up, chop it. I told y'all I was gonna chop off the little bits on the edge. I'm gonna save that for next time, or maybe tomorrow. You see the process on the rears? That's the way I did it. I'm sure there's a ton of more professional ways to do it, man.